Hey guys, how are you today? I am actually reviewing the Shade Light palette from Kat Von D. This is the contour palette that she came out with, and I am so excited to show it to you. This palette is $42 or $45, I can't remember. I got it at Sephora a while ago, and I'm so excited and so happy that I got it. I have enjoyed it, and it has actually taught me a lot. So so this is the packaging. It's cardboard, but it's like super solid, super thick. This stuff is not gonna bend. It's not going to, you know, it has a magnetic closure, so it's pretty solid. And I like it. I think it looks super cool. It looks super badass, and I totally love it. In the back, it has the names of the actual powders that it comes with. And over here, when you open it, it comes with a mirror and the contour kit. So this is what we're talking about, right? So let's start talking. So it comes with 3 contour and bronzing shades and then 3 highlight shades. I really like the variety that this has, and it has allowed me to experiment with contour, with bronzing and all that stuff. So I have enjoyed it a lot. I can tell you that these are the 2 colors that I use the most. I always used to use drugstore contour shades. The only non-drugstore that I used was the NARS Laguna and the Chocolate Soleil. And the Chocolate Soleil is pretty cool tone. I think the NARS Laguna is still kind of warm tone, but I've been watching a lot of videos about contouring. A lot of people say the best shade for contouring is the cooler tones, because obviously a shadow is more of a cooler tone than a warmer tone, right? And while I still think, because I have such yellow undertones, I still have to add a little bit of warmth to that contour so that it doesn't look too fake or too drawn or too just like there. I still feel like it does make sense, you know? So anyway, so this is the color that I use for contour, but I always add a little bit of this bronzing shade over here. I will let you know the names. So this one is called Levitation. This one is called Lyric. This one is called Lucid. This one is called Subconscious. This one is Shadow Play. And this one is Somber. Okay? So yeah, so these two are the ones that I use for contouring. I mix the 2 of them and it looks perfect. Over here, I feel like it looks looks natural to some extent, but I mean, come on, we all know I'm wearing makeup, right? But it still looks very nice, and you can put it as light as you want to or as dark as you want to. I can tell you that because of my skin tone, I stay away from this one because it's just too dark. I don't need that deep of a color, but it's still nice to have around because I can use it for eyeshadows, and I'll talk about that a little bit more later. But so I love these 2. I can tell you that for highlight, there's nothing that I love more than this color right here. This color is called Lyric, and it's a very yellow undertoned highlight, and oh my gosh, all of these are matte. Okay, so that's the first thing that I should have mentioned, is that all of the products in this line are matte. There's one that kind of has that kind of hourglass or the color icon kind of minimal pearlescence to it, like, but it's so absolutely minimal, it's like not even there. I mean, it's matte for all intents and purposes, okay? So it's so amazing. So this color is definitely my favorite, but I can tell you that I've experimented with these 2. And while I don't feel like I like them so much for highlight on the face, like, I still use them sometimes and I have no issue with it. This one is beautiful for under the eyes. Like, it's such a perfect color to highlight under there after you put your concealer on. It's pretty amazing. So yeah, so all of these are really good. Now let's talk about the quality of the powders. I used and I made a review of the City Color Contour Effects powders, right? And I told you how buttery they were. These aren't as buttery as those, but they're definitely good powders. They're not the softest thing ever, but once you go to apply it, they apply so nice. They're so easy to blend and so easy to kind of move around your face that it makes it really easy. I have no issues with it whatsoever. What else did I want to say about it? Oh, yeah. So the other thing that I wanted to mention about this is the fact that I can totally use it, or you could totally use it, for eyeshadows as well. For a person who enjoys matte shadows as much as I do, and neutral eyeshadows for as much as I do, this is such a perfect palette. Like, I could probably take this and a blush to, like, a trip and be totally cool with, you know, very smoky eyes, very natural eye looks, and I'll take care of my eyes and my face in one thing. So for those of you who are into that stuff, this may be worth your while just because of that. It's pretty amazing. I feel like they last a very long time. It's pretty amazing. I do wear, you know, foundation and powder and everything. So, and I do wear a makeup extender, so I feel like that helps it to last a little bit long. But at the same time, I feel like this on its own lasts for a long time. So I have no issues like contouring my face and then having nothing. No, there's times that I haven't put a setting spray on, and I've gone exercising and everything, and I've sweat and everything, and I have no issues with movement or fading or anything like that. So it's such a good product. And overall, I mean, you get this huge mirror, which is such a good plus, and I actually love this product. I feel like it's pricey, so I mean, and there's so many other palettes, but for example, I feel like this one I like better than the Contour FX, just because it has way better highlights. It has, so it may not have the consistency, but it definitely has the different options for different skin tones, for experimenting, for eyeshadow looks, that it's just so worth it. And you basically have an eyeshadow and a contour palette, contour highlight here. So overall, I think it's totally worth it, you guys. I think you should definitely try it. It'll help you play around and experiment with different looks and everything. So yeah, I really like it. I hope you enjoyed this video, okay? Talk to you later. Bye. Because when you first try it and you go like, I haven't tried any like creamy products for the eyebrows. So when you go to dip it, you end up with a lot of product on your